Good morning, Out Late But Great. This is Jason, your Tuesday, and hopefully you guys had a great Super Bowl weekend. I know I did. The Giants won. So I guess that's why I'm wearing my big blue right now. I supported the Giants because they're out of my division. So even though my Redskins lost this year, they beat the Giants twice. Maybe once or twice, I can't remember. But they beat the Giants twice and they're not in the Super Bowl, really? Andre also got back this weekend, so I'm very excited. He was on a month-long mission in Hawaii. I don't know why he came back, but he should have come get me at the same time right now. But he's back, and I'm very excited that he's back. And our viewer topic this week comes from Brother Derek, and thank you, Brother Derek, for asking questions. And we do encourage our viewers out there, if you have any questions regarding LGBT, to go ahead and definitely ask. We'll definitely love to answer those questions. We'll put them in sometime. And even if it's like another question not regarding LGBT, it could be a bonus question for us, and we'll definitely put that in if we have a chance. There are times where we actually get so stumped that we don't know what to ask for the weekend. We take turns asking questions. So having your questions definitely helps us in the long run. So yeah, definitely ask away, people. But Brother Derek asks, being LGBT in the healthcare system, was being LGBT a factor in terms of quality of care? Did you out yourself where you found out if you have been out as an LGBT patient in the healthcare system? What have your experiences been like? Well, first off, I've actually worked in a health insurance company before, and I'm not too sure if any of the LGBT outlaters have actually worked in healthcare, but I've worked in healthcare, and I've worked with a lot of the complaints that come from patients regarding doctors or hospitals or anything like that, and I've worked with that. And I've never seen any type of discrimination complaints. So I'm not saying that they're not out there, but I rarely see any complaints regarding LGBT or discrimination against people. So a lot of doctors work off of how many patients they see. And if they do discriminate, I'm just gonna say basically stupid for doing that, because they're not catering to their customer base. You know what I'm saying? But I've never seen anything like that in healthcare just of yet. And I know there is, but I think with time, I don't think doctors are going back in time and discriminating against people who are gay, lesbian, black, or white, or who, they're not discriminating against that. I think that more of, you know, they're looking to care for the patients, and that's what they get into the business for. A lot of doctors do go into the business because of money, and they rather have money than just taking care of a patient. You know what I'm saying? So, and there's a lot of laws out there, like the HIPAA laws and everything like that, that do govern a discrimination like this. So definitely, don't be afraid to go to a doctor and tell them that you're gay or lesbian or transgender. A lot of doctors might not have knowledge of it and might refer you to a doctor that does have knowledge of the LGBT community. You know, for me, when I was in Hawaii, I did have a doctor that was gay. And it was easy for me to express my concerns and everything like that. If I got a bump here or there, you know, I was able to express that in a way where it's more comfortable for me. And I know people have a hard time looking for doctors that are gay friendly or lesbian friendly or transgender friendly or LGBT friendly. Let's just call it like it is. And it is hard to find those doctors. How I found the doctor was through a magazine that one of our local clubs at the time actually gave out, and I think it was Odyssey. I can't remember the name of the magazine. And they had doctors in there that actually took patients. And it was great to have that, because I was able to go and see that doctor and create that rapport with him. And he was a very gay doctor. Let me just tell you, he wore a lace shirt. One of my doctor's appointments, he came in with a lace shirt that showed his chest and nipples, and I was like, is that very appropriate for work? But, you know, whatever. To each his own. So, yeah, there are ways to find LGBT doctors that are very open to the community. Here in Killeen, I'm having a hard time finding that because there's not a big LGBT community here. However, I know there are doctors that are very friendly to the LGBT community. So they're out there. You just have to ask around your friends, family, whatever, or, you know, Google search them. There might be doctors that are out there that will take you on as a patient because they feel comfortable. You feel comfortable with them, you know? So I've never had a problem with expressing that I'm gay in a doctor's office. So I can't really answer the question in a negative sense. So, and hopefully Brother Derek wasn't looking for a negative sense, but yeah, I've never had any bad experience. My doctor currently right now, he doesn't know that I am gay. So I can't really say anything about that and say that he knows and he's fine with it. So maybe in the near future, I'll definitely let him know. But yeah, quick in and out procedures or whatever, or doctor's appointments that I have. So really not a big thing at the doctor's office. So hopefully that answers your question, Brother Derek. And you know, there are websites out there or magazines, or if you go to your local club or anything like that, they sometimes have doctors in their local magazines that do take on these type of things. So hopefully that helps, and it helps someone out there find a doctor for that. But anyways, I will catch you guys later. I love you guys, and have a great week. I'll see you next week.